right up here, and we don't miss very much. There's no time limit on a pull. You pull until the referee calls the pin. And a pin is made when the hand, wrist, or forearm touches the pin pad or falls below. If you get cupped in steep, there's no more daylight between the pad. It's a parallel pin. Don't let that happen, because that's just the same as touching it. The forearm and wrist must not be covered with any clothing or bandage. So if you got a long sleeve shirt today or an Ace Band-Aids, get rid of it. Roll it up or something. Raised platform shoes are okay. We also bought a small platform for some of the short people here today. Contestants decide which side of the table they prefer. If no mutual agreement occurs, we'll flip a coin and decide who gets closest to true north or whatever. I don't know. Start position. Right hand locks in a thumb-like grip. The elbow is in the bottom of the cup. The left hand holds the hand peg, and at least 1 foot contacts the floor or the floor framework. You can wrap your leg around it, you can push it against the bar, and you can juggle those two legs back and forth as far as that goes, as long as 1 foot maintains contact with the frame or the floor. If the feet come up momentarily, it's a warning. If they come up again, it's a loss. In the start position, if both wrestlers want to see their thumb knuckle, then you can't ride high. If you want to see the knuckle, the referee's going to make him come off. A thumb lock is allowed, so if somebody thumb locks and you're climbing up on the other guy's knuckle, you're going to have to let him show it if he wants his knuckle shown. Thumb lock's okay. If they both thumb lock, we as referees can't see the knuckle. You just got to start you without your knuckle showing. That's if both guys choose the thumb lock. Starting the pull, referee will take hold of the contestant's hand, straighten them, and say ready. So if you're not ready, that's not a command as much as it is a question. You better let us know real quick. If everything's straight, we're lined up in the center, nobody's leaning over, the wrists are straight, we'll get a start like this right here in the front one. Ready, go. Okay, it's a pin on this side. So if you're not ready, don't say you're ready after somebody slams you. Let us know, I'm not ready, he's climbing up on me, he's kicking me under the table, whatever. Okay. The foul line's on the table. You look at them day when you get up here and help us lock you up. We want them even with or behind. You can't start with your shoulder in real tight. They've got to be square. But after a go, run another one. You can use shoulder rollers and come in with your shoulder. Go. And you can pin. You can cross that line. Everything like that is okay after the go. If we get a false start today, and a couple guys are trying to really get a hold shot on the speed, ready, go. And if both of them jump, it's a foul for each of them. If one guy just jumped, naturally it's one foul. If you jump once, you better not do it on the second start. There's two fouls on a false start constitute a loss. If we get some matches today where there's a lot of fighting for the grip, and that is critical, we know, and we can't get them locked up, we're going to ask for a 30-second count from the scorer's table. If in that time they still haven't locked up, you'll set your elbows down at the bottom of the cup, open your hands, and the referee will set your hands. Once the hands are set, you can't pull out. We're going to set them fair, so once we lock them up, we got to get a match. Anybody pulls out of it, it's a foul. Okay, breaking grip. We got a strap today if this happens. We forgot it last time. If the grip is broken straight up in the neutral position, or real close to neutral, go each way just a tad. Yeah. Okay. That's going to be a rematch because you're breaking straight up. It's going to be a rematch with the straps. And then once those are put on, we're going to get us a pin because you're not going to get out of them. If the grip is broken in the losing position, it's the responsibility of the arm wrestler in the losing position to maintain grip. So if Mike can't maintain it there, and we can see obviously that Terry is not letting go, it's going to be a loss. Also, as far as bent wrist goes, if you bend an opponent back and you've got him on your side of the table, we're going to tell them the wrist is bent and to straighten it. If within a count of five they have not straightened it, it's a loss. Also, as far as the bent wrist goes, bent wrist in the winning position is allowed. Makes it difficult sometimes to pin, but that's a go. That's completely legal. Okay, we went over the bent wrist position. On the count of five, both feet off the floor. And intentional headbutting. We don't get them that much on a wider table. The shoulder touching the pin. peg. The hand peg is to your advantage that your left hand's holding. Don't lose contact with it, not even momentarily. I don't care if you keep your pinky on it, or your thumb, or whatever, long as you're always having contact with the peg. If you lose the peg, it's an automatic loss. It's not a restart, it's a loss, so don't lose the peg. The reason for that is Terry gets in trouble, and he goes, I'm going to let go of the peg because it's a restart. It's not a restart, it's a loss. Okay, allowing the elbow to ride up on these padded donuts, when you go to pin, these big forearms are going to hit the side and just ride up about a half inch within the circle of that donut. That's okay because the forearms are hitting the padding, but you cannot lift your elbow to pin, and if you pin while you're lifting your elbow, it's a loss. If you raise it up, dunk somebody, it's a loss. If your elbow bounces up momentarily, and you get it right back in, it's a warning. If you use your elbow again, raised up, to gain advantage, it's a loss. Let's see, so we don't want it right on the side, and we don't want it completely off. If it comes completely out of that cup and on the side of the table, you've got a loss. Okay, we're going to let you know about getting in tight today. That's okay. We want you in there where it's at, the action, and keeping an eye on your hands at all times. If you really do, men, women alike today, if you keep an eye on your hands, you'll always know what's going on. Don't look away from them. It causes you to twist into bad position anyway. And us referees are not coaching anybody today up here, but we'll tell them if they're twisting, not to twist, and to keep your eyes on it. Okay, just one last thing, and if you got any questions, let me know. Okay, using your shoulder, your big head, your anything else, your own body to touch your hand or your opponent's hand to gain an advantage. But before he even gets to that position, we're going to warn him. We're going to want to see daylight. We're going to say, back it off. You're almost touching. You're touching. Then if he touches, he just momentarily brushes it, he's got to warn him one more time, and that's it. So if you pin, when we start a match, ready, go, and Terry flashes him with his shoulder on his hand or Mike's hand, it's a loss. But we're gonna, like I said, we're going to warn you about coming. When you even get close, we're going to give warnings. We're going to let you know what's going on. Because sometimes you don't know. You don't know where you're pulling so hard. So I guess we'll start off with the 160. Does anybody have any questions? Ask them now. Yeah. No, if you pin with it, there's never a warning that could be issued. So if somebody fired in, Gerald, and they did it with the shoulder on top, it's going to be a loss.
But at the same time, if you're pulling with them like that, and you touch it, then it's a warning?
That's right. Well, you can't have any arm wrestler up here, Gerald, really, firing on a guy with his whole body and dunking him and using his body on it. It's a loss. I mean, because you know that if you come in that close, it's almost got to be deliberate that you're laying it on there. It's not body wrestling. If you do it with a pin, it's a loss. Same as if you raised it up and dunked him, it's a loss. If we didn't call that, we'd see it all day long. You know, sometimes you'll have a baggy shirt on. You'll just be brushing, not knowing. But if on a go, you know, your first move is to fire, your shoulder's laying on top of it, and that's the way you crush your opponent, that's a loss. And anybody that's arm wrestling knows where their shoulder's at. Yeah, you'll get a warning. Exactly. You're right. Okay.
Thank you. Wilson and Ron Boutel on deck. When we call your name to be on deck, please come up and warm your arm up. There's weights up here on the stage. Bobby Wright and Doug Curry on the table now. Jamie Eggleston and Ron Boutel on deck to warm up your arms. First pull of the day in the 0-160 weight class.
Jason Ross.
Joe Frederick in the 191 and up weight class. You're on deck. Tommy Cannon and Joe Frederick. David Fuller and Jason Ross on the table.
Hey, sir. Like I said, I've been coming so long for this, it's terrible.
Ready, go!
Winner's name.
David Fuller.
David Fuller takes the match.
Get him, Joe.
Tommy Cannon and Joe Frederick in the 191 and up class on the table.
Thank you.
Doug Curry.
Doug Curry takes the match.
Come on.
David Snyder and Eric Ewell's on the table.
Ready, go!
you want an up weight class, you're off the table. Yeah, Bill Armbreaker.
Yeah. Give it up. Not for nothing.
No, no, no.
Bring it up.
also ready to get back underway. We are going to start with the 0-160 weight class. Eric Ewells and Lanny Julian in the loser's bracket are on the table first.
You are on the table.
20s.
Right there, both of them. Don't move your hands.
Man, go ahead and
tell them now.
West, David Ranker, Allen in the yellow, David. in the blue.
Danny White takes third. Danny comes.
good here for food or drink all day long. In the 161 to 190 weight class, David Fuller takes third place. David, please come to get your award.
That's it. As awards, we have for third place, we have a certificate. Second place is $25 and a certificate. First place is $75 and a certificate.
At least we can drink no more.